How y'all doing today? For today's video, we're going to look at how to install Fishfinder mapping Chartplotter combo unit. This one is from Lowrance, the Elite 5 DSI. It has down scan imaging, which is pretty cool because it actually gives you a more photorealistic type picture on the sonar scan. Now, I already have a unit. It's a different brand. It's a Garmin, but this one had a good price and lots of features, so I went ahead and got it, and I'm going to install it today so that I'll have two units to act as a backup, and also I can run a Chartplotter on one and the sonar on the other, vice versa, or split screen. So, first thing we're going to do is find us a spot to mount the transducer.
Alright, I'm not sure how good you can see down there.
Here's my other sensor equipment. Here's the transducer for the Garmin. This is the speed sensor. And the transducer for the Lowrance unit is much smaller. I think we're going to mount that right here. A little bit close to the trim tabs, but I don't think it's going to interfere. I don't want to get in the middle because that will upset the water flow pattern to the prop. So I don't want to introduce any kind of turbulence into the prop. I want smooth water in the prop. So looks like this is going to go right about here. Now I am going to have to.
So on second thought, I decided against making a third hole.
What I'm going to do is attempt to get this off, the speedometer sensor opening, and just make this hole bigger enough to accommodate the transducer and the vacuum line for the speed sensor. Then we'll probably just do away with that clip.
But to make my transducer hole, which will double as a transducer and vacuum line.
All right, now for the scary part, the drilling the hole through the transom. Now, inevitably, I'm gonna get some fiberglass on myself, which may prove to be itchy. You probably wanna exercise proper safety precautions, maybe use an air mask and cover your skin to not get these fibers on you. As usual, loser. Say, not as I do. Oh, I believe we have a winner. Once I pull this through, what I'll do is I'll back feed that vacuum line back through. Even though there was barely enough room for the plug, there's plenty of room for three wires, you'll see. And I'll caulk that hole up real good from both sides, similar to the one you see next to it. All right, I've kind of mocked up the bracket. Around here, fairly close to the bottom. Instructions call for a 29-bit.
that is gonna work. Now I'm gonna straighten it and readjust it, but right now I'm gonna take those screws back out, dab a little adhesive sealant. Into the grooves before I permanently tighten up these screws. After a short break, I'm gonna lower the motor, open up the access port, and feed this wire through. Alright, we were a little hung up there. Now, if my plan works, or works, in a second you'll see the other tube come back through. This looks pretty good, even looks like there's a little bit of extra tubing so that I can clip. All right, I'm gonna get a couple wrenches to tighten this up. A little click up or so. And then I'm gonna go ahead and fill this full of sealant to seal up this hole. I actually might go look for one of these hole downs and put that hole down right there. Alright, I wouldn't call this my best work by any means, but this seems to be about straight. Now there's plastic parts here and also some rubber grommets in between, and I think that I may have already gone too tight judging by how compress those rubber grommets are. So I'm gonna back up a little bit. Alright, and although the instructions say to let this point out with the boat, in my experience these transducers always work better if they're angled down just a bit. So we'll start angled down. Enough, so I'm gonna drill that just now, but drilled the pilot hole. Alright, and now I'm going to attempt to seal up this hole. This sealer is the off-brand, well maybe not off-brand, it's Atwood. I typically use the 3M sealer. I do think we are sealed. It's kind of sloppy as for an install job, but, and I'm gonna leave it. I'm not gonna move any of the wires. Everything appears to be orientated right. All right, the next part of this adventure involves threading this cord through the boat. You see on my boat, I have an access here where I've pulled the cable through, I'm gonna have to remember to seal up the inside part of the transom where that wire's coming through, but I'm gonna wait and do that after I pull the wire through because there's gonna be a lot of motion and movement. I probably should have done all that before I sealed the outside too. All right, to do that, to fish it through, I'm gonna have to reach through that round port and get it into that backside compartment. From there, I'm gonna take this panel off, and then I'll have to devise some type of feed through. Maybe I can find some copper tubing or something, or fish tape to feed it through the rest of the way until I can get to the dash. Okay, so now it's several hours later. Just kidding. Several curse words later. You see my fish tape there that I went and got, and I just threaded it through for the second time. And you know, with all the stuff that normally goes wrong, it's just unbelievable when something actually goes right. I stuck the fish tape through, and would you believe, can you see that? That end right there is the fish tape. It came exactly out where I needed it. So now let's hope we can feed it through. It's taking longer than what I thought it would, but still plan on getting this done today. And now you can see my fish tape has made the journey the rest of the way. So I will just clip this in here. Hopefully this won't get caught on anything. You know what, I'm gonna go ahead and do a little bendy. I don't know if you can see that. That should just pull through. Let's see what happens. Alright, here's where my original Garmin goes, and I measured underneath because there's a fuse panel. Before you drill, you should always know it's on the other side. And I can't go any more than 11 inches from where this hole is. So this is right about 11 inches and about where we want the new Lowrance to be. So we are going to drill a hole there, and that'll be our hole for our new wire. Go ahead and try it out because we have the cable run. It's ran through the bottom, so let's see if it'll come through. So there we go. All right, now it's time to drill the holes for the mount. So let me swap out the drill bits. Make myself some little marks. Remove the units. So I'm gonna place a little bit of sealant. Each one of these. I'm going to use some dielectric grease on these connectors eventually, but I don't have it up here with me. All right. Left now is the electrical component on the bottom. It comes with a noise reduction. I was gonna wire this and do both, but I think I'm gonna leave the old one. It works fine the way that it's wired, and go ahead and wire the new one with its noise suppressor, since it has the down scan imaging technology that the Garmin doesn't. This one's about 7-8 years old. Still works good. It's color. I thought it was a 5-inch, but this 5-inch looks a little bit bigger, but they're both supposedly 5 inches. All right, let's power it up and see what we got. We won't be able to get sonar readings in the driveway, but we should be able to get some GPS markers. I'm gonna go disconnect the battery real quick so that we don't cause any shorts. And I don't know how much I'm gonna be able to tape down below during the wiring, but I'm gonna try to do my best. All right, we have switched to the cell phone camera. And here's our little hole. And our power connectors right here. All right, so what I've done now is connected the red power connector to the red noise reduction lead and the black to the black. Now I'll have to connect this noise filter, and I'm going to connect this to the same power leads that are running my other GPS. They're switched on the accessory button on the dash. So now I've decided that I'm going to put a slide-on connector for the ground, since I have plenty of ground connector slide-ons available. And this I will just wire nut. This end, the positive end, I'm going to wire nut to the positive for the other GPS. Okay. I know it's hard to tell, but here's where our ground connection ended up. And here is where our positive connection was made, which runs to a switch that powers both GPSs. Let's go try them out. All right, so we made our connections and everything is just about done. I just have to seal a couple more spots on the inside of the transom, and I'm going to take zip ties, and kind of tidy up those wires everywhere and make sure that they're not all banging around. So now let's turn on our power and let's see if our original GPS comes on. What we like to see. Boy, look at the difference in the color of the screen. Well, that's a wrap. Alright, so there you go. That was our video of an installation of a combo chart Fishfinder, Chartplotter. Kind of a tough job, I'll tell you the truth. I ran into a lot of problems, even with the fish tape. After what I showed you, the fish tape got hung up on the side of the boat. I ended up using electrical tape to make sure it didn't get hung up the second time. So, it was probably, I would call it an intermediate job. Maybe on a bass boat or something smaller, might be a little bit easier if you have more access to where the wires are going. But either way, I hope this video helped you out. If it did, leave me a thumbs up. That goes a long way to help me. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. Don't forget to check out some of our sponsors, because without the sponsors, videos like this would not be possible. So thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.